consider a rain barrel for their yard. But what type should you get? How do you install one? And are they even allowed? Today, we're getting answers to all your rain barrel questions. This is the Water Matters Podcast.
You're watching the Water Matters Podcast, brought to you by the Southwest Florida Water Management District. We answer your most popular questions about the work we do and the services we offer, including new projects, springs protection, water conservation efforts, and more. Learn about the many ways we serve the community and protect your water resources.
Welcome to this episode of the Water Matters Podcast. I'm your host, Michelle Sager, and today I'm joined by Colby Pitts, the Florida Friendly Landscape Program Coordinator for Hernando County. Welcome, Colby.
Great to be here.
Let's start with you explaining exactly what you do at the county and a little bit about what your job entails.
My main thing, I'm really public outreach for water conservation in Hernando County. That's the main thing I do. So I'm teaching classes, hosting and attending events, and answering a lot of phone calls and customer questions about FFL concepts and our watering rules.
When you say FFL, what do you mean by that?
So that's Florida Friendly Landscaping. It tends to be a mouthful, so I like to shorten it to FFL. FFL is based on 9 principles. Those are really readily found if you're looking for them. So those 9 principles basically make up the program, and they're all geared towards water conservation and conserving our natural resources.
So basically, Florida tips to help conserve water around your home.
Yeah.
And of those classes that you teach, I know some of them are about rain barrels, correct?
Yeah.
So let's start with the basics for people who are not familiar with rain barrels. What exactly is a rain barrel and what would you use it for?
Rain barrels are used to collect rainwater for later use. Typically, these are going to be set up under gutters, collecting rainwater that falls on your roof and goes through your gutter system.
And it's helpful because you can use it around the garden.
Rain barrel water is really good for watering bedded plants, potted plants, and even use it for washing tools, your car, windows, things like that. It's really good for watering plants because rainwater tends to be a little bit more acidic than our groundwater, and plants really tend to prefer that lower pH.
So they could actually benefit from that.
Yeah, it's a health benefit.
And if you're using that water, you may not have to use your irrigation system or your hose, so you're also could be potentially saving money.
Definitely. Just by nature of hand watering, you're already saving water because it's very targeted and on point, but you're also not using, you're using water that would have just ran off otherwise. That's kind of where the runoff reduction purposes of rain barrels come from too.
Can rain barrel water be used for drinking water?
I would say no. And the reason I say that is your roof and your gutters, which typically where the rainwater that's coming into your barrel comes from, it can be filled with all kinds of contaminants. And I urge you the next time you have a chance to look on the inside of your gutters and tell me if you'd like to drink out of it. I know at home, even though I try to keep my gutters clean, I wouldn't want to.
Absolutely. So stick to your plants, using it for those outside purposes.
Definitely
don't drink
potable water.
Don't drink the water. So we have a lot of residents that are new to the area, and they may not understand all the rules about rain barrels because sometimes they come from states where they're not allowed.
Sure.
So can you help us understand the rules for putting in a rain barrel in your community?
In Florida, there actually are no statewide restrictions on rain barrels, so that's a really good thing to know. And typically, your municipalities, local governments aren't going to have them either. The place you should pay attention to is if you live in a homeowners association. Those are the places that are typically going to make rules that might restrict rain barrel usage. So please refer to your HOA covenant on that type of thing if you live in an HOA.
And a lot of times, they're not keeping you from having them. It just might be rules on how they're installed or the color of them, isn't that correct?
In our Hernando County communities, we have a few HOAs that have rules regarding rain barrels, and they prefer that they're in the back and that they are a neutral color, which is why, as you'll see later, the ones that we have are a very neutral, they're beige, which tends to go with a lot of the houses that are in these HOA communities.
So you shouldn't necessarily feel discouraged if you live in a deeded community. Mm-hmm. You could probably still have one, you just need to check on exactly what the rules are.
Definitely, and it's rain barrels are one of those things that there's not really a negative to. So I've had people in my own experience have luck talking to their HOA and saying, hey, this is something I like to do. It saves water. It's good. As with many other FFL principles, and the HOAs tend to listen and they tend to want to implement these changes.
That's
so it might be good to advocate for rain barrel usage in your community.
Now, one thing I do sometimes get questions about and hear about is, what about mosquitoes? Because you have this water sitting there. Is that going to breed mosquitoes or attract them?
So it definitely can. It's really important that you pay attention when you're purchasing your barrel that you're looking for a screened lid with a fine enough screen that mosquitoes cannot get in. Most of your purpose-built barrels that you're buying from your big box stores, those are going to have a lid and you shouldn't worry about it. If you're building your own barrel, it's important that you buy a fine enough screen. If you do end up with a mosquito infestation, using products like BT, which is a bacterial pesticide, that's not going to harm any of your any of the uses. It's not going to harm your plants. You can still wash your windows, your car, your tools, etc., without having without being a breeding ground for mosquitoes.
A typical rain barrel, how long does it take to fill one up?
So it really can depend, but in typical setups, a half inch of rain, which we get in Florida pretty regularly, a half inch of rain is plenty to fill a barrel most of the time.
Okay, Colby, so you have been kind enough to bring one of these in for us, a rain barrel today. Can you kind of walk us through the different parts of the rain barrel?
So first off, we have the lid here. Now, on a lot of your purpose-built barrels, they're going to be kind of funnel-shaped. As you can see here, this screen that I mentioned earlier, this is a really fine screen that's going to keep out any debris or insect infestations, things like mosquitoes that's going to keep.
So that's a really important component.
Sure, and that's going to be in all of your purpose-built barrels. These typically come with those screens, but if you're building your own, you need to make sure that you're getting a really fine
screen.
So next up, we have our overflow hose.
And what does that do?
So the overflow hose is for when your barrel is full. And now, like we talked about earlier, people in Florida don't really have problems filling up their rain barrels. Mm-hmm. So a heavy rain could cause it to overflow. You're going to want to aim this overflow hose to your splash pad or to your French drain or wherever you have, wherever your gutter was dumping before. And this is going to prevent soil erosion and excess runoff.
And I noticed you have a part on the front. Is that where you're going to get your water? Like if you're watering your plants and...
Yeah, so this is going to be your hose bib, and this is really important. It's one of the things that I like a lot. This is one of the reasons why Hernando County uses this specific rain barrel. This hose bib is made of brass. That means it's metal. It's really going to last a long time. It's going to be less prone to failure.
And then I noticed there's another output over here. What is this for?
So this is a second overflow nozzle.
Okay.
Now, what you can do with this is if you have multiple barrels, you can daisy chain them together, allowing you to fill up. You know, these are 55 gallons a piece with two, you have 110 gallons of water. And you could continue that on, you know, in theory forever, to have as much rainwater as you can possibly stand.
So this is kind of a ready-made one, but if I'm building my own or purchasing just the barrel, what are the components I'm going to have to add myself?
So you're going to have to, with the lid, you're going to have to add a screen, have to add an inlet. You're going to have to add these overflow hoses. And the most important thing so you can actually access your water is going to be that brass hose bib.
And there's all types of different rain barrels out there. You can have fancy, basic. Do you have any advice on how to pick a rain barrel?
The main thing you really want to focus on is making sure that you have that screened lid that is fine enough that insects and debris are not going to get in. But other recommendations I'd have are look for metal hardware, look for brass hose bibs, make sure that you have sturdy hose clamps for overflow hoses and things like that. The brass hose bib is really nice, and I think once you've used one, you're not going to want to go to a plastic hose bib.
Now, obviously, you can buy them in stores, but you can also make them.
Sure.
If somebody wanted to make their own rain barrel, are there classes, are there videos? What should they do?
A lot of your local extension offices, your UFIPS extension offices, they're going to be the ones who are offering your rain barrel classes. Now, some of them sell purpose-built rain barrels. Others do a class where you make the rain barrel there. There is extensive documentation on not only the UFIPS extension website, but also the district's Water 101 program. There's also instructions there on how to build a barrel.
Obviously, you teach classes in Hernando County for residents here. But what if I live in another county? Are there classes available near me?
There definitely are. So every single county in the state of Florida has an extension office, and typically that's where those rain barrel classes are held. And if your extension office isn't holding a rain barrel class, they definitely know who is. So you should check with them. Definitely check with your local extension agent to find out about rain barrel classes near you.
And a lot of those classes are free or have a very nominal fee if they include the rain barrel, correct?
For sure. So I can't speak for every single FFL program in the state, but in our program, we sell barrels at our cost, and the attendance of the class is free. So you can actually get all that knowledge completely for free and then go home and build your own rain barrel.
Well, thank you so much, Colby, for joining us today. You gave us so much great information. And if you want more information about rain barrels, visit watermatters.org/water101. Click on the rain barrel icon for information with videos, downloadable guides, and more information about building a rain barrel. Thanks for watching the Water Matters podcast.